Hello everybody and welcome back to Stjernholm Reviews. Today, it's not enough just to create great content. All hail the algorithm. Tap, tap, tabaroo. The fundamental tool for achieving great sound is of course a great source, as what you hear can never be better than the source you're listening to. For many music lovers today, this involves some kind of streaming service coming out of a DAC. But what if you have a great sounding CD collection, vinyl, tapes, high resolution audio files, and maybe you also use streaming services like podcasts and internet radios and so on to fulfill all your music desires. In order to try to access all that with convenience and combine it with your favorite amplification and speakers, you would need to fiddle a lot with your computer, audio interfaces, different softwares, and so on. And to play with it and manage it all, you'd probably need a computer sitting next to your hi-fi system. Yuck. Personally, I love the idea of not staring into a computer or tablet to enjoy music and would like something tactile that connects me to the music in a physical way while still giving me all the access convenience that digital files and streaming can offer. Well, meet the top of the line music player, server, streamer.
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
Ripper, recorder, Cocktail Audio X45 Pro that seeks to be the ultimate all-in-one source recorder device to handle all your music needs and then some. Cocktail Audio is a brand owned by Korean IT company Novation. They decided to set out to create a consumer-friendly audiophile digital audio player device in 2006. The vision was to create a product that solved all the tasks we had to use computers for in a single product. In short, a pure digital music server with its own database, player and DAC, which have multiple functions like CD ripper, file playing,
346 minutes later,
DSD, MQA, and all the major music streaming services, and much, much more. The company has a wide selection of products built on the platform, ranging from pure digital players, all-in-ones, including products with a built-in power amp, hybrid all-in-ones to music servers plus DAC, like the X45 Pro reviewed here, all more or less based on the same software platform. Let me start by saying that I actually purchased a X45 Pro myself due to its unparalleled flexibility and sound quality, which makes it a great tool and a consistent source for comparisons for me as a tester and reviewer. But it's also a great example of all the bad that happens when a company basically don't understand what I call the emotional component of their products, failing to let the user experience guide the choices of functions and the overall design. The X45 Pro was clearly designed only using the logical part of the brain, so let's explore the many things it can do for you in logical terms. It aims to cover all bases, being a CD ripper and player, a DAC, a phono preamplifier, a AD converter, of course, a DNLA-capable network streamer, but also a network server, a Rune endpoint and MQA decoder, not to forget a FM and DAB tuner. It also streams all major music services with direct login and podcasts and loads of internet radio stations. And it even wants to be a slideshow player. Oh, and it's a high-resolution audio recorder too. For navigating all these numerous features, It has a 7-inch color TFT LCD display that can also be copied via the HDMI output. The X45 Pro can be equipped with the onboard storage provided by a 3.5-inch or 2.5-inch hard disk or SSD drive. I would strongly recommend to use SSD storage for absolutely silent and responsive operation. It has an audio board with ESS Technologies' latest Sabre DAC chips and precision electronics, with a lot of care taken in the layout, circuit isolation, and hardware design, resulting in a high-performant audiophile-grade high-end music player. In short, it's a huge Swiss Army knife used as a preamplifier, as I do right here. It can even drive digital power amplifiers via variable digital outputs. If I really nitpick, the only thing that I can find missing here is a balanced analog input for the series recordist and some extra trigger outputs to turn on external amplifiers. We can also connect USB hard drives, USB sticks, or as I do here, use a internal disk or SSD for local storage of file-based music. That means that the X45 Pro itself can hold all your high-resolution music, connect to computers, other DNLA servers, and or serve your network with DNLA services for playing back the files on other devices, like a smart TV in another room, for instance. Talking about network services, I find it quite annoying that the unit has to be fully booted, including the display, in order to deliver network services to other devices. And it's also the only DNLA server on my network that does not work very well. In regards to file formats, I have not come across anything that the X45 Pro cannot play up to the highest available resolutions in both PCM, DSD, as well as all lossy formats. So again, you would be hard challenged to find anything that this thing won't do. It simply does everything.
Everything, everything.
The different music repositories from say a Tidal or the music locally stored on board of the device are isolated from each other, meaning that you as a result cannot create mixed playlists on the X45 Pro containing a song from one of your own ripped CDs, for instance with a song from a music service, for example. It is like Cocktail Audio expects you to use one source for all your music and stick with that, more or less. It also means that the X45 Pro is not the unifying device for all your music that it really could be. It is more like a lot of devices in one that does not talk very much to each other. What the X45 Pro does very well, though, is turning this into this. Namely, moving a big CD collection into something more convenient without any loss of quality. And actually, ripping CDs in one-to-one quality is one of the potentially best ways of experiencing the best quality uncompressed audio. Straight out of the box, the unit needs a network connection in order to pull data from the internet and talk to the Neo X Music app if you want to use that. This can be either via LAN cable or via Wi-Fi if you have the optional Wi-Fi antenna. It is always best to keep all files on the internal drive to eliminate any kind of potential network jitter. I'll get back to this in another video. When internet communication is established, you just feed the beast some CDs. In the setup menu or in the app, you can select what format the CDs are ripped to. Choose WAV files for uncompressed sound and BEST for the optimal error correction when reading the CDs. It is always a good idea to clean the CDs beforehand to make the most smooth transfer. You can also rip to lossless FLAC format or even MP3 to save space. But personally, I would always prefer WAV as it is a true one-to-one PCM copy without any alterations to the original data. Storage space is cheap, and you can store many, many CDs on a 2 terabyte SSD drive. So why not keep all the bits? Another advantage of this is that if you later want to convert the files to save space or use your music on another system, it is best to convert from an uncompressed PCM format like WAV, where you have many more software options available. Oh well. The X45 Pro itself is also capable of doing format conversions if needs be. Silly me. CD metadata is pulled from Gracenote. Commercially released CDs is almost always accurate in that database. In the default album view on the device, you can browse the CDs in the sequence in which you ripped them, or they can be sorted in various ways. This is where the X45 Pro really starts to add value, because with your CD collection transferred to the X45 Pro, you can rediscover the collection in a number of cool ways. How about playing by mood and then ask the player to play random songs in that mood? Great! To me, this is one of the party pieces of the X45 Pro. Imagine it would mix in your streaming music services as well. But unfortunately not. The learning curve when first getting acquainted with the X45 Pro is pretty steep. You will have to consult the big manual in many cases to be able to get the most out of it. On the other hand, if you just want to use the X45 Pro to rip your CD collection in full quality, browse and play the albums, daily use is pretty simple. The player can be used with the controls on the front, which to me is the most delicious way of interacting with such player. Unfortunately, really simple and obvious things like skipping to next track or searching by text input is not available here. To do that, you will have to use the very comprehensive, but also very clumsy plastic remote control. You can also connect a computer keyboard. In all cases, the commands differ depending on what input method you use. And I find it annoyingly hard to navigate, even after using the unit for months. The key commands used are not logical or on par with anything else you might know. So in order to use it well, you will need a key command sheet of paper lying around. Novation kind of insists on doing the navigation according to their programmer logic, instead of relying on principles that are commonly used by, well, almost everybody. Or how about FN control arrow down for the next track? It is not hard to imagine how the programmer simply made a lottery with all the commands they needed and then drew from a random pile when deciding on the key commands. I can best illustrate the lack of human attention to the user experience by showing you the contextual menu offered when playing back a track. It kind of captures the essence of the daily use of a cocktail audio player. Now we are playing a track. What would the most likely functions that you would want quick access to be here? I would say things like adding a song to a playlist or skipping to the next track, make a track a favorite or something along those lines would be very natural choices. But in Cocktail World, they came to the conclusion that the most wanted feature you want to directly access when playing music back is... Lastly, there's the app that has recently been released in a brand new version called Neo Music X. Some things like browsing the music on your system becomes a little easier with this new app that is said to have been vastly improved over the previous one. But the app is hard and uninspiring to navigate, and I easily get totally lost. Editing metadata is a real pain, if at all possible, and getting cover art is cumbersome and on a per-track basis. Again, the X45 Pro has all the features you could possibly dream of on paper, but it becomes hostile to use in real life, especially if you want to use more advanced features like editing playlists and metadata. Oh, and did I mention that sometimes the app will not even connect to the X45 Pro on my network? But only sometimes. Without getting into much more detail about the interaction experience as such, as it would take hours to cover, I think it is safe to say that I'm yet to come across a product that has such an incoherent user interface across the various types of user input. There's absolutely no real logic to it. Something you can do with one method, you can't do using another, and vice versa. So, is it me that's a complete idiot? To find out, I sat one of my very tech-savvy AV installer colleagues in front of the X45 Pro that he never seen before in his life. I gave him the big remote and asked him to create a playlist and put two tracks in it. It took him over 20 minutes just to figure the basics out. And this guy is a systems integrator that knows programming. Imagine if I have asked him to record something, edit it, add metadata, cover art, and add it to the database. He would probably still be sitting there looking like... The X45 Pro is more like a super multi-tool for the mad scientist than it is an emotional link component that connects you with the music. The 120-page manual have been required reading for me on the night table, and I still get lost in the device sometimes. And I'm a guy who have been working with complex digital professional equipment for a lifetime. The X45 Pro builds on the company's X45 model, but adds high-end CNC machined casing and more attention to the internal components, DAC and power supply. The result is a 20 kilo, more exclusive feeling audiophile product with a superb sound quality that rivals any high-end digital players. In the middle of the device, we have a CD ripper drive and a big, very clear but pretty unsatisfying display. Even though it invites you to touch it, it's not a touch display, but instead user input is done via the right rotary dial that doubles as a click function. The left rotary dial is for adjusting volume and muting if you are using the unit as a preamplifier, as I do here, as a centerpiece in your system. It's a shame that the two dials, despite feeling better than the base X45 model, feel so cheap. Or maybe it is the poor interaction with the software that makes them feel so cheap. There is multiple clicks that sometimes feels a bit random in between interactions on the screen. So maybe that's why the dial does feel less connected to the software. Judge for yourself. It's safe to say that the logic of one click, one line has not reached their programmers yet. I'm not friends with the layout of the front plate as well, where the important buttons are placed below a dial. It makes it hard to see what you're doing when using the dial. Most of the time, your hand will simply be covering the buttons. Cocktail's intentions are probably that you want to use the app or the remote. I totally acknowledge that it's not easy to design such a versatile player to satisfy every user scenario, but navigating on the unit itself, to me at least, is the most important emotional component. We also need to talk more about the display itself, as it is clearly selected to be durable and have strong brightness, more than being a delicious cover art display that has emotional impact. For instance, look at the color accuracy here. Obviously, not something that is deemed important at Novation to reproduce cover art in a spectacular way. Again, to me, a testament to the lack of emotional commitment. Enough about all the user interaction. Let's dive into something the X45 Pro does really well. The sound coming out of it. For my sound review of the X45 Pro, I have used a couple of great CD players and the Sony HAPZ1 ES file player for a detailed comparison, all connected via the analog outputs to utilize all analog components and built-in DACs. I use the balanced outputs connected to a fully balanced Marantz PM10 reference amplifier. So what I hear is the actual sound of each product's DAC and amps. In this comparison, the X45 Pro comes out as a clear winner. It is sonically very clear and focused. It has great resolution and a very sweet top end. Ripped CDs, high-resolution DSD and PCM files are presented with a deep soundstage with fluent, fast dynamics and a dead silent background. It is a really wonderful performer that does not add much character to the sound, but simply presents it in a very precise, competent and convincing natural way, with a slight added warmth compared to my fully digital options. That's why it has become my reference sound source in most situations. The bass is smooth and detailed, but some might find that it lacks some fatness. I prefer the type of bass precision that the X45 Pro delivers though. I'll say you get top-notch sound all around, and it feels very competent and trustworthy. Another thing that becomes apparent is the difference in the presentation between playing back a ripped CD over the network from my server or playing back the same rip locally from the SSD drive. I find the local playback to sound convincingly better and more settled. An interesting observation that is something I will do some more testing on. Network jitter artifacts could be in play here, maybe. Please comment below if you have insight on this. This in itself could also be a reason for using a solution like the X45 Pro in order to play back files locally instead of over a network. I will work with this and talk about it in a later video at some point.
Well, old buddy. Feel like spending some of your hard-earned money?
So here we are at the very hard conclusion. The X45 Pro is a fantastic sounding hi-fi system centerpiece that does the task of ripping and re-exploring your CD collection in new ways very, very well. One could simply add a great power amplifier, like I do here, and have a complete system with the X45 Pro as the centerpiece doing all the tasks, including radio. It is simply a Swiss Army knife like no other and perfect as a carry-on music source that will connect everything. And by carrying on, I mean bringing to a friend, bringing to a test, connecting to some other guy's hi-fi system, for instance. It's a product that can cover your every logical need when and if it arises. You will never be bored. There's always something new to figure out and overcome if you really want to get under the skin of it. In short, despite its very impressive feature set, where you will be really hard challenged to find anything this thing won't do, the result of wanting to do everything is that there's only a few things the X45 Pro does really well. It has a surprisingly large number of bugs that is coupled with a surprisingly low number of official over-the-air updates from the manufacturer. It is by far one of the products in my career where I have to consult the manual multiple times, which makes me think that many users, unfortunately, will simply give up trying to use the more advanced possibilities of the X45 Pro due to that hostile interface. With the unit, I even managed to delete my entire library by error after ripping over 1,000 CDs. No. That specific happening should not be possible with the latest beta software reviewed here. That employs a whole new way of referencing the files in the database. I'm not sure that this update is actually publicly available yet, but check the website. The X45 Pro is, despite a price tag of 4,000 euros, amazingly high-end sound value. Its extreme versatility makes it perfectly possible to use as a centerpiece in an economical high-end setup. If you're looking for all the features of the X45 Pro but at a lower price, have a look at the Pro's little brother, the X45, that boasts all the same features at less than half the price of the Pro. You can also go much cheaper than that by exploring all the other Cocktail Audio models that is built on the same type of user interface. With the X45 Pro, you get a very competent, high-end sounding player, also with a price point way below the feature list. It's simply a product where your brain says yes, but your heart says no. To me, it becomes a product I tolerate for its practicality in many areas, but not a product I love. A complete rethink of the software interface focused on user empowerment could change that. To judge how it works for you, try one before buying. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to help out that almighty YouTube algorithm by tap, 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 and subscribe if you like the content.